Hello everybody, my name is Kara, and today I'm here with my August TBR. So once again, I am participating in way too many readathons for 1 month, but I'm really excited about them, so I'm doing it anyway. I will put all of the dates and the information and the creators and everything like that in the description bar for all of the readathons I'm going to talk about today. So I'm going to start with my TBRs for Fairy Tale-a-thon and for POC-a-thon. Those two readathons actually overlap quite a bit. I think they have almost the exact same dates, so I thought what a great opportunity to read some really diverse fairy tale retellings. The creators of POC-a-thon are Min Kobayashi, Kevin from Storyglyph, Justin from Ghost Reader, Paolo Mancera, and Diana from Diana in Color. Fairy Tale-a-thon is hosted by A Bear and a Bee Books, Alex's Fiction Addiction, The Lost Reader, Erica E. Reads, and Coffee, Cocktails, and Books. And I know I just co-hosted Retellathon like a few weeks ago, but what can I say? I love fairy tale retellings. Modern Myths. Read a fairy tale, original or retelling, published in 2017 or 2018. And I'm kind of bending the rules a little bit for this first challenge because there is a new release that I really, really need to read, and it does sort of work, and that is Children of Blood and Bone by Tomi Adeyemi. This is not a direct retelling of any fairy tale as far as I know, but I know that this book heavily incorporates West African folklore, and I think that kind of fits in with the theme. The second challenge is Tale as Old as Time. Reread an old favorite or read a retelling of your favorite fairy tale. And one of my favorite fairy tales, or I guess like Disney versions of the fairy tale, is Rapunzel or Tangled. So I'm going to be reading Grounded, The Adventures of Rapunzel by Megan Morrison. And I really don't know too much about this one, except that it was highly recommended by Giselle from Giselle Bradley, and I really trust her fairy tale recommendations. And also, not that this is important, but look at that hardcover. That's pretty cool. The third challenge is There's No Fairy Tale Without Fae. Read a book with Fae or set in a Fae world. For that one, I'll be picking up The Slanted Worlds, which is book two in the Obsidian Mirror series by Catherine Fisher. I read the first book a really, kind of feels like a long time ago. One of my absolute favorite aspects of it was the Fae world or the Fae characters. The fourth challenge is Out Your Own Front Door. Read a fairy tale from a heritage outside of your own. And for that one, I picked Shadows on the Moon by Zoe Marriott. This is a retelling of Cinderella set in fairy tale Japan, and it's got really great reviews, and I'm really excited to see how this one, like how the setting and everything really works into the story. Also, the tagline says, "This Cinderella doesn't crave love, she only wants revenge." So, pretty excited about this. Number five is No Damsels Here. Read a fairy tale where a woman saves the day. Love that challenge, by the way. And I'm going with Spindle by E.K. Johnston. This is the companion sequel to A Thousand Nights, which I recently read from her, and I just loved that book so much. And I'm really excited. This is, of course, a retelling of Sleeping Beauty. Judging from what I know of the other book I've read by E.K. Johnston and just kind of her writing in general, I'm pretty sure that the female character is going to be the one who saves the day. Question number six is The Road Not Taken. Read a fairy tale, original or retelling, that's been on your TBR for a long time. And I will be picking up Six Gun Snow White by Catherine M. Valente. This is going to be a really interesting kind of Western-inspired Snow White story. And finally, question number seven is The Merry Crew. Read the group book, and that is Sea Witch by Sarah Henning. I don't know if I'll be participating in that challenge because I'm not sure if I'll be picking that book up in time, but I'll be interested to see how everyone likes the group book. And then moving on to the reading challenges for the POC-a-thon, I think it was Kevin's announcement video where he said that they came up with the challenges more as like prompts or suggestions, like you don't have to feel obligated to complete all of them. They're kind of like guidelines for how to diversify your reading, which I think is really cool. And I'm going to show you that pretty much most of the books I have picked for the Fairy Tale-a-thon fit into the challenges for POC-a-thon as well, at least for a few of them. The first challenge is to read books with main characters from three different races, ethnicities, etc. They can be in the same book, but they all have to be main characters. And I will be reading books that have West African characters, a book that has Japanese characters, and a book that has Arabian or kind of Middle Eastern characters. I'm not actually sure of the particular country or region for this one. The second challenge is to read a classic book by an author of color or a translated book. I don't know if I'll be completing that one. I might add in a book later. The third prompt is to read a science fiction or fantasy book by or featuring people of color, and once again, I'm definitely covered because all of these three books I mentioned feature characters of color, and Children of Blood and Bone is also written by an author of color. Tomi Adeyemi is a black woman. The fourth prompt is to read poetry by an author of color, and that's another one that I don't have one ready for at the moment, but we will see. And then the fifth challenge is to read a book that deals with racism, prejudice, or immigration. And once again, I am using Children of Blood and Bone by Tomi Adeyemi because the central plot or conflict of this book, I believe, revolves around the persecution of a certain group of, I think, magic users. So that is my TBR for a fairy tale-a-thon and for POC-a-thon. Lots of overlap between those two. With pretty much the same three books, I'm realizing now, they count for a lot of the categories, which is really great. I am so excited to read these fairy tale retellings. I'm so excited to read these very diverse fairy tale retellings. And now, moving into the Newt's Magical Readathon. This is a month-long readathon that was created by Book Roast. You take subjects that you qualified for by passing your OWLs. After I finished the OWLs, I kind of did a catch-up mini readathon, I guess, so that I could have lots of options for the Newt's readathon, because I decided that I would pick a book for every single one of the 36 challenges, so I could just kind of decide which subjects I want to pursue. I don't think I'm gonna get to all 36, but I wanted to have options. Can you guys tell that I am a Ravenclaw? Yeah. So I'm not going to show you all 36 books because that would take forever, but I'm just going to show you the first challenge of each of the class kind of categories so you get kind of an idea of some of the books I might be reading. The first subject is Ancient Runes, and the first challenge for that one is a book set in the past. And for that one, I will be picking up The Ugly Goddess by Elsa Marston. This is an ancient Egyptian historical fiction novel that I absolutely loved as a kid. The first challenge for Arithmancy is to read a book of at least 300 pages, and I will be reading American Panda by Gloria Chow. And our main character is a Taiwanese girl who is expected to marry a Taiwanese boy and go on and become a doctor, which is what her parents want for her. But there are several problems with that. One is that she is extremely germophobic and she absolutely hates her doctor training. And another problem is that she starts falling for a Japanese-American boy, which is definitely not what her parents had in mind for her. I feel like this is going to be such a wonderful contemporary that is sweet, but also has a lot of depth and, like, family interactions. And this book squeaks in at 310 pages, so just barely made it there. Next is Astronomy, and that is to read a book that has stars on the cover. And I will be picking up The Girl of Ink and Stars by Kieran Millwood Hargrave. I had this on another TBR, I think kind of recently, and I didn't get to it. I feel like it's going to be, oh, I even have a bookmark in it from when I intended to read it. But I think this is just going to be such a lovely, like, whimsical kind of fantasy story, and I don't know too much about it, and I'm gonna keep it that way. Care of Magical Creatures has the first challenge to read a book with an animal on the cover. For that one, I will be picking up The Stone Girl Story by Sarah Beth Durst. This cover has a stone kind of griffin raven creature, and I am just so fascinated by this premise. It's about a girl who's made of stone, and her family is too, but something about the spell that keeps them as kind of living stone, or stone that is able to move, starts to wear off. So I think her parents are, like, frozen or something, and she has to go on an adventure to, like, get her family back to normal. The first challenge for Charms is to read a book with magic in it. And I'm a fantasy lover, so this shouldn't be too difficult. But the one I've kind of tentatively picked for this challenge is Tom's Midnight Garden by Philippa Pierce. This is a magical kind of garden story about a boy who every night, I think, gets transported back in time. I just feel like this is going to be a really atmospheric and wonderful, like, children's classic, and it's giving me kind of vibes from The Secret Garden and Chronicles of Narnia in a way, so I feel like I'm gonna love this. And actually talking about it, I'm getting more and more excited to pick this up, so maybe I will stick with this for my pick. The first challenge for Defense Against the Dark Arts is to read a last book in a series. And for that one, I have chosen Banished by Betsy Hsiao. This is the third book in a kind of mixed up, mashed up fairy tale series that I am really enjoying. It's very, like, tongue-in-cheek, there's a lot of humor, but the second book was so much darker than I was expecting, and the ending of that one just, like, blew my mind. The first challenge for Divination is to read a book set in the future. And this will be another reread because I am quite behind on a few of the BookTube rereadathon prompts. And that is Fairest by Marissa Meyer. This is a prequel in the Lunar Chronicles world that really follows the life and kind of story of Queen Lavanna. Although you are supposed to read it, I think, after Kress. Like I said, I've already read this one. And the challenge for this is to read a book that you didn't like or that you felt disappointed by. The first challenge for Herbology is to read a book with a green cover. And for that one, I have picked a graphic novel, and that is Monstrous by, where is it? By Marjorie Liu and illustrated by Sana Takeda. This is an Asian-inspired fantasy cyborg steampunk kind of thing, and I am really excited for this. Sam from Thoughts on Tomes loves this series. I think it's, like, one of her favorite graphic novel series. The first challenge for History of Magic is to read a book that you think would fit right in at the Hogwarts library. So for that one, I picked The Apprentice Witch by James Nichol. Like, if you saw this in a Hogwarts library, I think it would look like, oh, a guide to how to be a good young witch apprentice, or, like, how to get started in the magic industry. The first Muggle Studies challenge is to read a book written by one of your favorite authors. And this is another reread, and that is Swift by RJ Anderson. This is a kind of traditional fairy story that is also set in the modern world. I hope it's not like cheating that I'm including a couple of rereads on this list. I actually didn't plan it that way. And the first challenge for potions is to read a book that has a name of a color in the title. And you're not really supposed to double up on challenges for this readathon, but I do think you are allowed to double up with this readathon and other readathons. So I will be using Six Gun Snow White by Catherine M. Valente. And finally, Transfiguration says to read a book with a gray cover. And for that one, I have chosen The Crying Rocks by Janet Taylor Lyle? Lissel? I'm not sure how to say her last name. It's about a girl who was adopted and she lives with her aunt and she doesn't really know where she comes from, but she's always felt like she stood out in her predominantly white community. And then one day she discovers that her family may have been members of the Narragansett tribe of Native Americans, and I believe this book is about her kind of coming to terms with her heritage and going on an adventure to maybe find out who her family was or who her parents were. Okay, everybody, so that was just some of my incredibly overambitious August reading plans. Please let me know in the comments if you guys are participating in any of these readathons or if, like me, you are participating in all of them. Because why not? Thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you soon with another video, and I hope you love the next book you read. Bye!